Has your faith ever slowed or blocked your scientific research, or vice versa?
I don't think it's slowed or blocked it at all. If anything, it's probably unblocked it. Because when I'm stuck, again, in grad school and research, high-risk research, most of what you do doesn't work, right? And you have to just be incredibly dogged about persevering. And I've always felt like I could go pray about these things, and inevitably, I just get these ideas that are pretty neat. The whole idea of affective computing came to me one night when I was, I'd been kind of complaining about my commute, and I was reading in the Bible where it says, "Don't grumble and complain." So like, okay, I should try this and see if it makes things better. I'll stop grumbling and complaining. This is really hard, by the way, especially once you have a teenage son, who's wonderful, by the way. But it's real. Parenting is much harder than being a professor at MIT, and being married. All these things are challenges in life, right? So I have a long commute. And so I was grumbling about my commute, and so I started praying about it instead, and I just had these really peaceful commutes, and all of the affective computing came to me on my commute one night going home, this whole new area, right after that experience.
And how about the other way? The questioner wants to know, has your scientific research ever blocked your faith?
No, actually not. I think they're both about trying to find out what's true, and I'm... this is a journey to find out what's true, and so far the tests I'm putting Christianity through and the tests I'm putting science through are, the best reasoning and experience tests that I can put things through. It doesn't mean that I swallow everything a Christian says. And remember this, to become a scientist, you have to go through all this elite training and education. Right, to claim to be a Christian and to say things that Christianity says, you don't need any credentials at all. So there's a lot of junk out there, right? So you don't just want to believe anything anybody says is Christianity, right? There's a lot of stuff that isn't Christianity, that's masqueraded as it, and certainly a lot of things people do that aren't Christian, but the person says they're a Christian, right? And they make all Christians look bad. But again, there's no credentials or certification bar, out there to before you're allowed to claim you're a Christian in the press. So do be careful. But I think scientists, we've learned to be careful. I'm careful and skeptical when a scientist says something that I'm not sure about, right? You don't just take something on faith because a scientist says it either. You test those kinds of things. So, and the Bible actually calls us to prove all things, hold fast that, which is good, to test things. So that's completely consistent.
For more information about the Veritas Forum, including additional recordings and a calendar of upcoming events, please visit our website at veritas.org.